You all know the Bible is made of testaments old and new. You've been told it's just those two parts, only one if you're a Jew. But what if I were to tell you there's a fresh third part out there, which was found by a hip new prophet who had a little Donny Osmond flair? Have you heard of the All-American prophet? The blonde hair, blue eyed voice of God. He didn't come from the Middle East like those other holy men. No, God's favorite prophet was All-American.
I'm gonna take you back to biblical times, 1823. An American man named Joe living on a farm in the Holy Land of Rochester, New York.
You mean the Mormon prophet Joseph Smith?
That's right, that young man spoke to God.
He spoke to God.
And God said, Joe, I think people need to know that the Bible is in two parts. There's a part three to the Bible, Joe. And I, God, have anointed you to dig up this part three that is buried by a tree on a hill in your backyard.
Wow, God says go to your backyard and start digging. That makes perfect sense.
Joseph Smith went up on that hill and dug where he was told. And deep in the ground, Joseph found shining plates of gold.
What are these golden plates? Who buried them here and why?
Then appeared an angel. His name was Moroni.
I am Moroni,
the All-American angel. My people lived here long, long ago.
But don't let anybody see these plates except for you. They are only for you to see. Even if people ask you to show the plates to them, don't just copy them onto normal paper. Even though this might make them question if the plates are real or not, this is sort of what God is going for.
Joseph took the plates home and wrote down what he found inside. He turned those plates into a book, then he rushed into town and cried.
Hey, God spoke to me and gave me this blessed ancient tome. He has commanded me to publish it and stick it in every home.
Wow, so the Bible's actually a trilogy, and the Book of Mormon's Return of the Jedi? I'm interested. Now, many people didn't believe the prophet Joseph Smith. They thought he'd made up this part three. There's a verified tree on the hill in his backyard.
Liar!
So Joe said,
this is no lie, speak the God of the time, and he told me to head west. So I'll take my part three from the hill with the tree. Feel free if you'd like to come along with me to the promised land.
The promised land?
Paradise on the west coast. Nothing but fruit and fields as far as the eye can see.
Have you heard of the All-American prophet? He found a brand new book about Jesus Christ. We're following him to paradise. We call ourselves Mormon, and our new religion is All-American.
Wow, how much does it all cost?
The Mormons kept on searching for the place to settle down, but every time they thought they found it, they got kicked out of town. And even though people wanted the golden plates, Joseph never showed up.
I'm not actually a Mormon.
Yes, he is. Well, anyway, now comes the part of our story that gets a little bit sad. On the way to the promised land, Mormons made people mad.
Joseph was shot by an angry mob and knew he'd soon be done.
You must lead the people now, my good friend Brigham Young.
Oh God, why are you letting me die without having me show people the plates? They'll have no proof I was telling the truth or not. They'll have to believe it just 'cause
Oh, I guess that's kind of what you were going for.
The prophet Joseph Smith died for what he believed in.
But his followers, they kept heading west. And Brigham Young led them to paradise, a sparkling land in Utah they called Salt Lake City.
And there, the Mormons multiplied and made big Mormon families, generation to generation, until finally, they made me. And now it's my job to lead you where those early settlers were led long ago.
A set of steak knives!
All American!